So guys, here we finally have the brand new Windlader update, Ladashi 2.7.3, and the performance you're seeing right now speaks for itself. This emulator has become an absolute beast. It now supports Snapdragon 8 Lite Gen 5, and as you already know, the games that GameHub fails to run properly, Windlader handles them easily, and that too with solid FPS. The funny thing is, most people still avoid this emulator because they think it's complicated. But in this video, I'm going to completely break that myth. I'll show you how insanely easy it is to set up Windlader Ladashi 2.7.3 by following just a few simple steps. This emulator is running smoothly even on low-end devices. Yes, even a Snapdragon 720G can run GTA 5 at around 15 to 20 FPS, which is honestly crazy and one of the biggest highlights of this update. So let's jump straight in and see how to properly set up this emulator in the easiest way possible. I'll explain everything step by step so clearly that literally anyone can run it just by following along. And yes guys, Mali GPU support is also available in this emulator. Most users fail to run games on Mali devices only because of wrong settings, but in this video, I'll show you exactly how to fix that and make it work smoothly. So without wasting any more time, let's get started and unlock the real power of Windlader Ladashi 2.7.3. So now, come straight to the official website of this emulator by simply searching Windlader Ladashi on Google. Once you land on the site, you'll see that there are three different builds available. The first one is the official default version, which is stable and works fine for most users. The second one is the powerful build with Bionic, and this one also includes an Antutu build, making it the fastest and most performance-focused option overall. And finally, the third build is specially made for Snapdragon 8 Elite Gen 5 devices. So if you're using the chipset, this one is clearly for you. After choosing the right build for your device, simply install it and open the emulator. Now guys, if you really want extreme level performance, this is where things get interesting. Head over to the settings, then go into the performance profile, tap on edit, and create a new profile. Inside this profile, enable safe lags and set its value to 0. Trust me, this single tweak makes the profile insanely powerful. You can name this profile Extreme for easy identification. Just keep in mind, this Extreme profile is supported mainly by known AAA titles like GTA 5, GTA 4, and Tekken 7. For unknown or less optimized games, it might not work properly, so don't panic if a game fails to launch. This setup is purely meant for maximum FPS boost. After that, if you want faster cursor movement, you can simply push the cursor speed to full. Leave all the remaining settings on default, because touching unnecessary options can actually reduce stability. Step number 1. Now guys, tap on the plus icon at the top and create a new container. Step number 2. Next, you need to select the resolution. For low-end devices, I strongly recommend going with this resolution. Gives you the best balance between performance and stability, especially if your device struggles with heavy loads. Step number 3 for Mali devices. Now pay close attention here. If you're using a Mali GPU, it's better to select the Proton ARM 64ES Wine version. This is the same Wine version used by GameHub, which is why it feels so stable there. But here's the advantage, since Windlader is more native, using these settings can actually give you even higher FPS compared to GameHub. When you move to GPU selection on Mali devices, use the system driver. For DXVK, select the ARM 64EC build, and choose either 2.3.1 or 1.10.3. These versions are known to be stable and performance-friendly for Mali GPUs. Now again, step number 3, but for Snapdragon 8 Elite or Snapdragon 8 Gen 5 devices. For these high-end chipsets, the setup is simple. Use the system driver here as well, and for DXVK, select either 2.3.1 or 1.10.3. In general, 2.3.1 and 2.4.1 are considered the most stable options, so you're safe with either of them. Step number 3 for normal Snapdragon devices, like the Poco series or low-end chipsets such as Snapdragon 720G. Here, instead of the system driver, you should use the Turnip driver. If you want even better results, you can update the driver directly from the emulator by going into Settings and then Adreno GPU drivers. These Snapdragon devices also support the ARM 64EC Wine version, which gives you around 20% extra performance, almost like native gaming. If you want to push it further, you can also select ARM 64EC DXVK, which activates this performance boost instantly. Step number 4. Now head into Advanced Settings, set the preset to Extreme Mode or Performance Mode, and then simply run the game. That's it, guys. With these ultra extreme settings, you can now run GTA 5 or any other game you have with maximum performance. This setup is designed to squeeze every last bit of power out of your device, so just follow the steps properly and enjoy smooth gameplay.